So, were you to put it into words, what would you say was Richie's mistake in blue?
He divided by 2x on both sides instead of subtracted 2x.
Did Richie divide by 2x?
Or just by 2x.
Okay, divided by 2. Yeah. Who else said divided by 2?
I didn't.
Something like divided by 2, divided
by
2.
Well, I said that. You need to take 24 away first.
Take 24 away first?
Oh, I mean like get the x to the, sorry, not 24, but hit the x to the one side.
Okay. So I have here a little prediction that most people would say divided by 2 or some variant of divided by 2. Divided by 2. And saying, like, what he should have done instead is kind of like saying, well, he shouldn't have divided by 2 yet. Now, is it wrong to divide by 2 at that step?
No.
No.
Good. It is not wrong to divide by 2 at that step. His mistake is that he chose to divide by 2 and he divided by 2 incorrectly. Okay? So, first let's look at what I would do and what most people would do at that step rather than what Richie did. And then we'll do what Richie did, but we'll do it correctly. So instead of what Richie did, probably most of us would say, let's take 8x equals 2x plus 24, sorry, minus 24. And do what next, Jack Kyler?
Minus 2x
on both sides, which gives us 6x on this side, negative 24 here. Then we divide by 6 and get x equals negative 4, right?
Yeah.
That's what we would all do. But that doesn't mean that it can't be done some other way. Let's do what Richie tried to do, but let's do it correctly. So 8x equals 2x minus 24. So you decide to divide by 2. Let's divide by 2 on the left side. 8x divided by 2 is?
4x.
Okay, well, it seems like you did that just fine. Okay. So what did we do to the left side? Divide by 2. We divided the left side by 2. What did Richie not do? He didn't divide the
right
side by 2. He divided some of the right side by 2, but not all of it. Right? Over here we have 2x's. We also have negative 24 ones. We both need to get divided. So we get x minus 12, right? And subtract x, I get 3x equals negative 12. And if I divide by 3 on both sides, I get x equals
4.
Negative 4. Just like this one. Of course, if we do the same thing to both sides and we do it correctly, we'll always get the same solution, all of us. So the mistake wasn't divided by 2, we just didn't divide both sides by 2. If you were looking at this problem at this stage, as I would recommend that you do exactly what it did in orange, that you subtract the 2x from both sides, like do it that way. I think it's a little more simple. But I don't want you to think that dividing by 2 is the wrong thing to do. And it can get kind of tricky, especially if you're looking at an equation like 4x equals 3x plus 7. Okay. So if I do like Richie did, and I divide by 3, I'll do it correctly though. Well, now we have 4/3 x. 3x divided by 3 is x, but then 7 divided by 3 is 7/3. Now we're in a quite a pickle, right?
Subtract 7/3
from the left. Good. Subtract 7/3. But then we have a 4/3 x and we have 7/3. So essentially, we have x's and like pieces of 1s. Like they're not the same, they're like apples and oranges. So we wind up with 4/3 x minus 7/3. Equals x. I don't know what we have to do. Chris?
I don't. I'm sorry.
Well, now we put it right back to this. Right? Oh, we could go back. We could back
divide
back if we wanted.
I know.
What would you do?
Divide by 4/3 on each side of the equal sign.
We're kind of complicating it by doing the same kind of a thing as we did up here, dividing both sides by 4/3. But I would recommend not dividing until you just have something times x on one side and then a number on the other side. I would just save it until the very end if possible. I would just say, let's
subtract.
Whoa. What's that?
How did you get rid of that 7?
Get rid of it?
Yeah.
I don't know what you mean. certainly can always do whatever we want with x on both sides. And if we do 4/3 x minus 4/3 x, we get 0 x. And so now we're at negative 7/3 equals...
-1.
Very good. We got 3/3 of an x there, right? 1 x. Minus 4/3 x is negative 1/3 x. Okay, now we're getting closer. Now what? Divide by negative 1/3, or Daniela?
Oh, wait, never
mind. Maybe you get a common denominator there.
Yeah, I thought it was, I forgot that you could, once you subtract and enough, you could go into negative.
Oh.
I forgot that, so I was like, what?
Why is it negative?
Makes sense, but because
I don't understand.
Don't understand what?
Like how you got from 4/3 x minus 7/3 equals x. Can't you just do that right there though?
Do, are you talking about the step?
Yeah.
So minus 4/3 x and minus 4/3 x.
Yeah. And then how did you get 1/3 of there?
Okay, how about like a sidebar here? What if I had 3x minus 5x? What would that be? 2x.
Negative 2x.
Negative. We got more negative x's than positives, so negative 2x. Okay? Let's just say I know I'm going to have some x's. How many x's will I have? I'll have 3 minus 5 of those x's. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Okay, so same thing here. How many x's is this?
1.
I'm going to subtract 4/3 x, right? So I'm going to have 1 minus 4/3 x's. Just like 3 minus 5, that's the coefficient of x, negative 2 x. Here I do 1 minus 4/3. But what would I need in order to do 1 minus 4/3? Common denominator. Common denominator. So this would be 3 over 3 is the same as 1.
Mm-hmm.
What's 3/3 minus 4/3?
1/3. Negative.
Negative. That's what we got in the negative 1/3 x. So, then someone said divide by negative 1/3. Which is great. But I would always recommend instead of dividing by a fraction 2, instead of dividing by a fraction,
multiply
by the reciprocal. I'm just going to do that. I think that's a little easier to look at. Multiply by the reciprocal, multiply this by the reciprocal of negative 1/3, so negative 3 over 1. Multiply by negative 3 over 1. So negative 3 over 1 times negative 1 over 3 is a positive 1. We have x here.
Would it equal 7?
It would. Negative times negative is positive. The 3's cancel each other out. We have 7. You know what would have been a lot easier? Is if I concentrate on canceling all the x's on one side and... I don't like saying moving them to the other side, because you're not at all doing that. You're taking some away from one side and the same amount from the other side. It would have been easier if from the very beginning I had done what? Kyla?
Just to cross out the x's, divide by 3.
Or just divide by 3 this time here?
Oh, I meant
subtract.
Subtract 3x. What's 3x minus 3x?
Zero.
No x's. They're all gone. Subtract 3x on the other side, what's 4x minus 3x?
X
equals 7.
Right?
So, if you have variables on both sides, really think it's a good idea to go ahead and cancel all the x's on one side. Whatever you did to cancel them on the other side, do the same to the other side. On one side, do the same to the other side, and whatever happens, happens. Okay? It's always a good idea to not have variables on both sides. Let's get the variables canceled out on one of the sides. Okay. So it's just a mistake that I've been seeing a lot. And I wanted to remind you that while you could divide by 3 at that first step, see all that work that we did? It could have been a lot easier if we just subtracted 3x on both sides to start with. Not wrong, just more complicated. Well, let's go ahead and clear off our desks. The homework review. This is on the homework that I just passed back. Jeff passed it back to me. Variables on both sides. Alright.
This one really.
Okay, let's understand what's going on here. A member, if kind of depends on how you look at it. A member gets to spend less than a non-member if they're a member for a while and use the gym a lot. A non-member doesn't pay as much as a member because you don't have to pay that big $80 up front, right? So a non-member is going to pay differently. So how do we calculate what the non-member is going to pay? Ida? Well, I guess we call it an expression. Something with X in it that would be able to tell us for X hours how much the non-member pays.
13X.
That's just for the non-member, right? What does that mean, 13X? Molly, what is 13X?
Well, it's $13 an hour, so you multiply 13 by the amount of hours you don't know.
A variable. Would you like to tell us what the expression for the member is?
For the member, it would be 5X.
Five times hours,
$5. Yeah, and then plus 80 because
you have to pay the fee as well. It's just like $80. No, 80 times X, right? Because we don't pay 80 per hour. Mm-hmm. The number of hours doesn't change the $80, right? Okay, I walked around. I was very pleased with the equations that I saw, the ones that I could look at. Well, what we're saying here is that for Chloe, whether she works out. As a member or a non-member this week, right? Just imagine she's like an out-of-towner. She's trying to decide, well, I'm here for a week. Should I get a membership and get that discounted hourly rate, or should I just go there as a visitor, a non-member, and pay the higher price per hour? And she works it out, and turns out it's going to be the same either way. So we're going to figure out how many hours that's for. So how do we transition this to like an equation we can solve, Kyle?
13x equals 5. X plus
80.
80.
80. Zero.
It's
more like zero.
Let's start clicking.
So, whether someone is paying $13 an hour or $5 an hour plus $80, they're going to pay the same. Well, Chloe is, because she's going to work. That's how many hours she's going to be in the gym. So, how do we solve this equation? Sarah?
Well, I'll get like rid of the X.
Could I do minus 13x?
Yes.
Yeah.
Could. Do either one, but I like the minus 5x because then what do we have now?
8x equals 8x.
That's one step away from being done, right? What should we do? Shout it out.
Divide by 8.
It's our instinct to divide when we see an equation like that, right? Something times x equals number, divide by the thing that's multiplied by x, divide by x. What is that word? That thing that's multiplied by x. What's the word?
It starts with the V.
Variable.
X is the variable.
No.
The number multiplied by the variable starts with a C.
Constant.
No, a constant is 80. 80 is a number that doesn't change.
What is it?
Constant noble.
No.
C O. E.
Cooperation.
F.
Coefficient.
Very good. Great solving. So what does x equals 10 mean to Chloe?
10 hours.
Very good. Very, very good. Okay.
Gosh, I did that so wrong. I thought it equals 7.
Take good notes.
Wait.
Yes,
Ada?
Well, Aiden's talking. You essentially start with 130 equals 130. And then whatever I do from there, subtract, add, whatever, like it's just supposed to have to still be the same. But yeah, I mean, it's a good idea to always check your work, plug that 10 in there, subtract 80 from both sides, you'll get 50 equals 50. If you don't subtract 80 from both sides, you get 130 equals 30. You get 1,000 from both sides, you get 1,150 equals 1,150. Okay, now I've just given you an equation, just dropped it right in your lap, made it easy for you. What did you do first? Looking for Bridger?
I distributed the 5 with the x minus 4.
Distributing, it's a great thing to do. 5x minus 20. Oliver?
Minus 2x.
Minus 2x from both sides. Well put. 5x minus 2x is 3x. 20. Next. Somebody new. Somebody newer. Somebody already answered. Or Grace?
Add
20 to both sides. Oh. 25 equals 80x. Aiden.
You divide
3
by both sides.
Divide both sides by 3, and you get 25 over 3 equals x. That answer, that's a great answer. If you get it as a decimal, what would the decimal be?
8.3, repeat it.
3. This is wrong. This is right.
Yes.
I got both of those.
Wrong.
I got both of those.
Right. Wrong. Wrong. Right. If you're going to insist on not giving fractions as your answers, which I've asked repeatedly to do, you better make it the right decimal. Yes?
I made it a mixed number, 8 1/3.
That's fine too. These are all equivalent to 25/3. They're all correct. Sarah?
So I dropped the first one. I subtracted 5.
Sarah's talking, please. Oh, but that's a negative 20.
Yeah.
That's what I
negative 20. Okay. All right, well, we did it.
I got both of them wrong.
I got one right.
The important part is to learn.
Yeah.
Right? Right. If you learned that you are getting it, that's great. If you learned what you did wrong, that's fantastic as well. When you get your homework review back, compare it to your notes that you just took. Molly?
I already figured that out.
Okay, well let's all do it individually on our notes, and I'm gonna come around and probably tell you that you're slightly wrong. Right, so what's an equation for the perimeter of this rectangle? Somebody here. It's all the same people. Kyler? Perimeter is, can you tell me what the perimeter means?
Yeah.
What does the perimeter mean?
it's everything around the outside.
Everything around the outside. Okay, so let's look at everything around the outside. We've got a 3. What else do we need to have the perimeter?
Another 3 down at the bottom.
There's another 3, so what should we do with those 2 threes?
Plus
add them together?
Yeah.
Okay. Not multiply them? Okay.
You can.
You can multiply by 2.
Yeah.
Okay, but so that's the perimeter?
No.
Not yet?
No.
What else do we need?
X plus x.
Plus x plus x. If I do all that, if I knew what x was, would it give me the perimeter?
No, you have to put, couldn't you just like put 3 times 2?
Oh, well, we can simplify it.
And plus, yeah, like that, equals p.
Equals p. There's the equation part, right? It's an equation, it's got an equal sign. Okay, so I asked for an equation, so it has to be an equal sign. We wrote the equal sign, and then Kyler, you put p. Why didn't you put x?
Because we're not talking about x. We're talking about the perimeter.
Right. X is this thing over here. It's not the perimeter. The perimeter is something different, so it needs a different name. Does it have to be the name p?
No.
What could be the name of the perimeter?
Y.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, Z.
Not X.
Oh.
So you have to skip X, W, Y, Z. Yeah, okay. So any of those 25 letters.
Six
letters in the alphabet.
26 variables.
Okay. So we've got our equation. Can we solve equations?
Yes.
Yes, we can solve equations, but we need something We need some information, right?
Yeah.
Right.
You can't tell me what x is, you can't tell me what p is. Okay, I'm going to tell you some information and then I want you to figure out some other information. I'm going to tell you that the perimeter is, say it is 28. Perimeter is 28, and I want you to tell me what x is. I need you to tell me what side, how long this side is. Okay, just do it in your notes. Do it in your notes. I'll come around. Let's just talk about the last time you did it. You probably took your equation. Oh wait, 2x, right?
Yep.
2x plus 6. And you replaced p with 132.
Mm-hmm.
I watched you do that. So that's what you did. And then what'd you do?
Minus
6. So we got 126 equals 2x. And then what did we do?
Divide by
2.
Double division.
X equals 6.
And x equals?
63.
Yeah. Now. Is that similar to what you did the time before that?
Yeah.
Yes, they're
and
all
the
similar.
Time before that?
They're all
yeah.
similar.
What is the same about what we did?
You're doing the exact same step, just different numbers.
Which steps did we do?
We're taking 6 away from p, and
yep.
then we're dividing that by 2.
Okay, so now, what would have been easier if I told you what p was and I wanted you to find x, or if I told you what x was and I wanted you to find p?
X.
Fairly easy, but what's easier?
Okay.
X.
If I told you what x was and you and I asked you to find p,
yeah, yeah,
because it's all over there. You just plug it in, do the thing.
Mm-hmm.
When I'm done, that's what p is. Right?
Yep.
So this is, I know it's not that much more difficult to find x, but if I made the equation that much more difficult, then it would be difficult to learn, right, gradually to do what we're about to do, which is to just rewrite this equation to make it the equation that's easy to solve for x, which means we just get x by itself, so that it's ready for p to be plugged in and for tell us what x is. It all comes down to the steps that we take to solve for x are the same every single time. So let's do it one more time, but we won't plug anything in for p. We'll just leave p as p. We're going to solve for x, but with p as p, not p as a number.
Oh, all right, yeah. How does that work? Because you can just, yeah.
You can just, yeah.
It's actually pretty simplifying.
Okay, so what we do to this equation is going to be the exact same thing we did to this equation right here. It's just that we don't have a specific number for p. But the same thing, we do the same thing no matter what we plug in for p, so let's do that and just leave it as p. So to solve for x, we're going to get x by itself like we did here. What was the first thing we would do?
Subtract
6. What does negative 6p mean?
Oh, wait,
it
would be negative 6 times p.
Is that negative 6 times p?
No,
so it's p
it's
minus?
P minus 6.
It's just p minus 6.
Oh!
That's all there is.
That's weird.
P minus 6. They're not like terms. They're not being multiplied. So p minus 6 is out of phase. Equals 2x.
Divide by 2.
Divide by 2. Divide by 2.
Minus 6 divided by 2 equals x.
6 divided by 2 equals x.
Bridger
even kind of alluded to that already. He said we subtracted 6 from p, and then we divided by 2. That's exactly what this says. We subtract 6 from p, and we divide by 2.
Mm-hmm.
So what's this equation ready to do?
Solve it.
Solve for what?
X.
Yeah, x is like solved for. All you need to know is what?
P.
What's p? I'll tell you what p is. You plug it in there, and like the steps of solving for x are done, and we just need to do some arithmetic.
So
x equals 6 from the number divided by 2, right? Let's see, you're there.
Is it the same homework? Credit.
Well, you didn't quite get through everything. So let's just do up to 12 for you guys.
Okay.
All right.
Which one
is
it?